Vajinogamo.
Friendships. The Buddha's teachings on how you make Sangha work are the same as how you make friendships or spiritual friendships work. And so when he visited one of his disciples in a remote town, the town of Alavi, you've probably heard the story before, he met a guy out there called Hataka, who he hadn't seen for 5 years. And the Buddha was very impressed and surprised indeed to find that there was a thriving Sangha in this town, when the previous time he visited, Hataka had been the only Buddhist there, the only one practicing there. And he already had a lot of friends, Hataka. Many of them had started meditating with him. They'd all become Buddhists. The sutta says 500. That might be an exaggeration, I don't know. So the Buddha said, well, how did you manage it? How did you build such a thriving Sangha? And Hataka said, don't you remember? Before you left last time, you taught me the four essentials of partnership, the four essentials of partnership, or the four means of unification. And so what Hataka said, he explained what he did. He said, when I can make a connection with someone through affectionate communication, then When I can make a connection with someone through giving, then I practice generosity. When I can make a connection with someone through affectionate communication, then I speak to them with kindness. When I can make a connection with someone through helping them out or teaching them Buddhist principles, then that's what I do. And best of all, when I can get into deep harmony with someone through empathizing, through discovering how much we've got in common with each other, as two struggling human beings, then that is the approach I take. I use those four approaches: generosity, kindly speech, bringing benefit, and empathy, the four means of unification. Very simple list to remember. And this gives maybe some clues as to how to form friendships and how to make ordinary friendships into sort of self-transcending friendships.